It's about that time. I'm Lux, and today we have episode number 43 of NBA 2K17, My Career. Today, we're going up against the Orlando Magic, baby! Those are my boys. Those are the boys. Those are the squad.
The 2K Sports Free Game Show.
So it should be a good game. Also, we have maxed out our mid shot. It cannot get any better. So give me the minis, boys. Give me the minis. I think I'm at a 76 overall for mid.
We get ready for this very special broadcast of the NBA. And tonight, our broadcast will be shifting to Denver, where we'll see the Nuggets going up against the Orlando Magic. Well, for Orlando, they've got an opportunity
Serge
tonight.
Serge Ibaka, one of the best pickups we've got. Unfortunately, we had to lose Victor Oladipo, which was really a player. I would have much rather kept Oladipo and just never got Bismack Biyombo, but it is what it is. Work with it.
Anytime you have two teams filled with this much athleticism, you know you're in for some highlight reel stuff.
One good thing we have is this is a little bit older. It's not exactly up to date. So this is before Hazonia got a really, really nice jump shot. I mean, it was good, but it wasn't as good as it is now. So luckily, I've been hitting too many threes. They are 19-24 in the season. We're 32-6. I'm not going to talk shit. I mean, there's a few players I want to talk shit about, like Bismack Biyombo. I'm going to talk shit to Evan Fournier. That's just what I do. I'm not a big fan of them in general or their play styles or their quote-unquote skill level, if that's what you want to call it they have.
Well, thank you, David. Brent has removed towards the middle of the season.
Alfred Payne's underestimated him. He's some of the best handles in the league.
This is a great
not the best, but I mean, he's
to
top five.
A few interesting concepts.
It'd be like Curry,
put in some new
Lillard.
Or defensively challenge his teams during
we'll
games
do that some other time.
Maybe they have a 15
get out of my house, Bismack. Bismack,
bitch ass
Biyombo.
The mind of a player really quickly throughout
I thought
the
I was gonna pull
the season.
That.
A look at the starting group for the Magic. The guard tandem is Payton and Fournier.
Oh my God, get blocked.
Biyombo is out there with Ibaka, and it's Green in at the small forward position.
There we go.
And finish off by Prez.
They don't have to double team me all day.
Watching Prez get after it on the offensive glass. So good at reading shot trajectories.
Jeff Green's
pretty
good.
Guessing correctly where to be on the weak side.
Ibaka with a screen on Chandler. The drive by Green. That's no good. Couldn't get his first shot to go.
When I'm saying R, I'm meaning Magic. Their biggest issue, let's say it that way, is their tempo of the game. They play super, super slow, but then still don't get good looks. So they play the clock down to get that good look, and they never do, so they just end up wasting a lot of time, which just breaks down the morale. So it's one of the biggest issues the Magic have right now is their pace of the game.
He feeds it to Fournier. There's the
fuck
pick.
Fournier.
Just five to shoot. It's
fuck Fournier,
by
like, legit fuck Fournier. Like, the kid's not good.
Young outside.
I don't know what the fuck Young's doing.
Screen by Fareed. In the corner, Murray with
that's
it.
Good. This one Chef Murray with the pop, boy.
One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
Well, if Murray can do
we're
that,
up 7-0, baby. Come on.
From the 3-point line, look out.
Chandler against
sorry about
Green.
That. You guys just heard my phone. My apologies. I'm gonna try to hold him in the paint. Nope.
Screen
try
by Ibaka. For three, Fournier. Kenneth Fareed pulls it in.
Like, Ibaka just set you up so perfect that Fournier chokes because Fournier sucks ass.
And the Magic's young tandem of first-round picks in 2014, Alfred Payton and Aaron Gordon.
So I'm going to tell you all of a story that pisses me off about the Magic's here.
On the team USA under 19
our mascot's name is Stuff, okay? Stuff the Magic Dragon, get it?
That was a great draft for the Magic.
So his number is zero. He's always been number zero, and that's what he does. When we picked up Aaron Gordon, he wanted to be number zero. But we said, no, we're not going to change the number of our mascot, so we'll make you double zero. He said, well, all right, I can deal with that, you know, first come, first serve, you know, seniority or whatever. He just took it to the head and said, whatever. Now we have Biyombo, bitch-ass Biyombo here.
And it's Payton with the assist.
Bitch-ass Biyombo here, who is number zero.
For Denver, they've gone 4 of 5 from the
yeah,
field so
go
far.
Fucking figure. What kind of bullshit is that, right?
here's Young, and he floats in.
Like, that's just triggering. Like, not only is Aaron Gordon better than Bismack Biyombo, but he was here first and should have got that first play call. Or if they were going to change, it should have been offered to him, since not only has he been in the league longer, but he's been part of the Magic longer.
And also in that one, he had the opposition on pins and needles on the defensive end of the floor, recording four steals that night,
like,
on his way to an overall.
It really pisses me off that Magic did that.
Here's Murray. Young outside. He kicks it to Murray. And the whistle blows. It's going to be
a hella foul, Jeff Green. Chill out. Now, Jeff Green's a very strange pickup. I feel like he's a good pickup, don't get me wrong. I feel like he's a very good player. However, he just hasn't found his place on the team yet. He's not hitting in the paint. He's not really shooting. He really just hasn't found his place on our team. And I missed that because I was thinking at the same time. So I really feel bad because, like, he's a good player. He just doesn't get to shine because he doesn't know what he wants to do.
Gotta
be careful because Gordon will get them rebounds.
So much talk about Gallinari and his size and skill as a shooter, but one of the big reasons why his game can expand is the fact that he can attack the rim and do it more frequently.
Has Justice ever missed the shot? I obviously know he has, but he's so good at, like, everything he does is insane.
Young with the,
like, look at that. Yoink.
Young running the floor all by himself.
So I have a question. If you, Young's my point guard, okay? So if I pick a point guard, does that mean that Young becomes another position? Or is he still a point guard, but then we just never get OJ?
Let's talk.
It's a good question. I'm going to find out. I'm just going to build a point guard and find out. Or I'm going to watch another YouTuber, because it seems like every fucking YouTuber has picked a goddamn point guard. Sorry, salty. We are up 34-12 at the middle of the second quarter.
Frez, he's in at center. Chandler,
what's up, big man? Bitch ass Biyombo, dog.
Murray out there with Young. That's the group on the floor for Denver.
I knew it was a bad block attempt. I'll take it, though.
Green,
I'd rather be safe than sorry.
Payton with the ball. He hasn't scored yet. That I'm
Biyombo
sure
can't hit
three.
So fuck that nigga. Him being out there is useless.
Here's Fournier.
That was my bad. I walked
Here's
too far.
Biyombo. And even after two Yetch. Offensive rebounds, they just can't get the lid off. The shot by Chandler, wide open.
Oh,
Denver
shit.
Gets it back.
Let's go free. Let's go free.
That's just a poor job.
Chandler's good,
defense,
but he's not guaranteed.
Fareed
is guaranteed.
You want to get
and Murray, oh my God. Chef Murray is so guaranteed. I know if I'm passing the ball, I can just transist because he's making it.
Ground to a standstill.
I need to get in the paint and help my boys where they need me at.
Reporting from the sideline.
Oh, that's...
Thank you, Kevin.
Yep.
Well, Prez in their last game against the Pacers was terrific. He ended up with 22 points and was very efficient on offense. He picked his spots on when to keep the ball moving or to shoot. That outing from him helped assure the win and enabled his team continuing its win streak. It will be interesting to see if the momentum carries on here tonight, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you.
Boom! Congratulations, you've unlocked the bronze relentless bag. What's good?
You know, I'll be interested to see how much he's got left in the tank. I mean, that performance had to take a lot out of him.
Yeah, that's got to be a consideration. He was extremely worn down because of that load that he carried.
Nobody's falling for that shit,
he's
dog.
Elite.
Fuck you.
I don't expect that from him. We'll see what he's got tonight.
Suck out of here.
Data chart tracking blocks and play, personal fouls. We see the last 10 games next to the season as a whole for Ibaka.
Ibaka's good. I'm very glad we got Ibaka. He was highly, highly needed. And if we would have had to trade Ibaka for Oladipo, then I was okay with that. Because Ibaka just, he shines on this team. He really brought Magic back to the board.
Well, it's been talked about to death the way the altitude in Denver can wear out the visiting team. With that said, Brent, for the first time in a while, the Nuggets haven't been playing at a very high pace.
I don't think that's the cup of tea for this current coaching staff, the way they've assembled things. And you wonder if not playing at a high pace doesn't make the most of a built-in home court advantage at altitude. But really, it's about your personnel. They have some plodding bigs and some young guards that need to develop. Why speed that up?
There's 154.
Keep your eye on
Fournier.
He's gonna play through him.
Shot clock
called
five.
It. You're so predictable.
Here's Payton. A three-pointer off
nice.
The mark.
I just wanted to make sure Biombo couldn't get the board.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Chandler, and they cash in right away with the quick shot. Chandler's got 4 points in the quarter.
I'm having a slower game, but I'm okay
with
it.
Because
we're just winning by
They're
so much.
Hit inside and getting good shots from close range.
Peyton dishes to Fournier. That's good. And it's Peyton Fuck with the assist. Peyton's got 3 assists tonight. The Nuggets leading by 23. Pass to Murray. He dishes it to Fareed. Some nice ball movement by the Nuggets. And a hard slam there from Prez to finish off the play.
And one, baby.
That's the athleticism that had him so highly touted coming into the league.
A different look for Denver. Terrell Arthur, he's checked in for Kenneth Fareed. Alinari comes in for Wilson Chandler. And it's Will Barton in.
Nice job, Orange
Bro,
Juice.
Bro, we are ruining. What are we up by, 34? Like, damn.
I love the energy, fellas. I really do. But now we got to keep it up and stay focused. Just keep squeezing that orange juice, gentlemen.
Just keep squeezing that orange juice.
Turns of points in the paint.
And through one half, it hasn't even been close. Nuggets ahead. Run.
Thank.
Don't get me wrong. There's no disrespect to the Magic. There's no disrespect to the Magic staff. None of that, dude. Like, I promise. None of that.
Bring it in,
like,
guys.
So, like, I don't know. I'm a Magic fan. I like the games. I feel like when watching a Magic game, it's so much different to playing against the game.
This is what happens when we play our brand of basketball. They cannot stop us.
Maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll make like an edit. Like the best highlights of this season from the Magic.
Thanks again for joining us. And welcome back to our special Martin Luther King Day presentation of the NBA.
Oh, it's Martin Luther King Day.
We're seeing a tremendous game from Prez.
Just a dominating performance in the post by him so far. Just tearing them to shreds when he gets it inside.
Yeah, is there a shot down there that he didn't show them? I'm not sure. Let's see if the D can make some adjustments here as we start the third quarter.
Checking out the group of Frank Vogel to start the second half. The guard tandem is Peyton and Fournier. Green is out there with Ibaka, and it's Biombo at the center position.
And I love the shot selection by Prez, playing well within the offense there and burying a lot of buckets in the process.
Ray, you had the chance to play under coach Greg Popovich during your 4 seasons with the Spurs. Aside from the obvious accolades and plaudits, what stands out to you about him as a coach?
The one thing about Pop that stands out, Kevin, is the simple fact that the rhythm of the season is something that he has a tremendous amount of control over.
Feel, had great feel for it.
There's no doubt about it. Pop is so good about understanding the feelings and the emotions attached to the game. And on top of that, the priority with which the game should have in your life. And that's the kind of player that they're looking for. They understand that the player has to understand the job, his accountability to his teammates, the role that he's asked to play.
Fuck
and then
Derby.
Lastly, just how important basketball
Everybody
is.
Everybody talking about
team.
Fuck me? Well, fuck y'all free.
Fuck y'all
free. Well, look at this. Fuck y'all free.
Even Greg Popovich, your former coach, said they weren't great for the sport. Do you see any truth in that?
Well, I think Pop's just upset that he didn't have as good a three-point shooters on his team over the past couple years. I don't think so, Kevin. I mean, the game is moving towards the three-point line
yeah,
and expanding the space and pace type of offenses that we've seen, and teams having great success doing that. It's really hard to fault a team like Golden State, who's the blueprint for that sort of activity, motion, and
scoring. Oh, I got locked down there for a second.
That was
pretty fire.
The copycat league is underway, so more three-pointers are coming.
From about 19 feet, and Denver again with the bucket.
And sharp here to start the half. That's 3 in a row.
For Orlando, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, we know Mario Hezonja is a sharpshooter out of Croatia, and some say he was the cockiest player from that 2015 draft class. He once said,
so
I've never had respect to anybody on a basketball court. I don't care. Whether it's a veteran or a young player standing in front of me, I always have the same goal. I want to run over everybody.
I agree.
Kevin?
What a quote. He is not shy. Thanks, D.A. Now, here's Fournier, not a lot of room. Screened by Ibaka. puts up a three. And it's Denver with the rebound. They defeated Indiana in their last game.
And how about the game plan that was constructed for that one? I mean, it was apparent how powerless the D was to stop it.
Yeah, offensively, they got all the momentum behind them, got the D on the ropes, and they just kept throwing haymakers.
And Brent, for the Nuggets, they know that it's going to be a growing process for a few years before they can compete.
Well, a lot of learning on the job, not only for the players, but for the coaching staff, Kevin. But that can be a great thing. You know, if you're rooted together in the struggle to become successful in the NBA, you're going to share those successes on such a deeper level once they come.
You can't get that one.
Can't put back, Brent.
And it's the Nuggets ball. They've outscored them 10 points to 2 during this run. And Young kicks to Prez. Young hooking up Prez on that score. Terrific play by Orange Juice.
And those two have such great timing together. They make the game look simple.
And the Nuggets with some changes. Gallinari, he's checked in.
I dropped it on him. Dog, see me drop it on him? I dropped it on him.
And it's Gary Harris in for Murray. So Orlando going with an almost entirely new group here. Aaron Gordon is checking in for Bismack Biyombo. Mario Hezonja comes in for Green. Jody Meeks, he's checked in for Evan Fournier. And DJ Augustine subbed in for Elfrid Payton. Here's Hezonja, and he comes off the screen.
Dude, he's so guaranteed. Hezonja's so good. He's so very, very good.
Didn't fully commit to it.
I guess they do have the
updated
version.
Just enough to get his teammate enough room to knock down the shot.
Oh, my God. I don't know who that is. It looks like Harris.
On the wing, Harris. He's guarded by Meeks. Good on the bucket.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score.
Trying to drop this 20 bomb on these bitches.
They've been looking
out
of sync offensively.
And they need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
It's Hezonja in the corner.
Really
left alone that time.
Fuck, man.
Hezonja's got 4 points.
God, Hezonja's too good. He's too good, man.
34 seconds left here in the third quarter. And Young kicks to Barton. Young outside. Prez with the screen for Young. Offensive rebound. And
I need to look at that badge.
Rise up for the jam. Just terrific at finishing those opportunities.
In the middle of dunking on kids.
Real strength of his.
Here's Augustine.
Yeah, they not
numbers.
Waste time.
He
DJ Augustine.
9 points a game. Gordon a screen. From deep three-point range, that misses, would have counted had it gone in. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead in this one may already have been decided. The Nuggets on top, ending the third quarter with a tremendous 17-6 run. And don't go away, we'll be back momentarily. Now let's listen in to Frank Vogel's huddle.
Look, they can't guard great passing. They're passing the ball great to start. We got to do that for four quarters.
When you give advice to do what to do for four quarters, you're already in the fourth.
Yeah, and
I say late, Vogel. Late.
For Denver, Prez is checked in.
We're about 24, dog. GG.
Comes in for Gary Harris. Young is subbed in for Moutier. So Orlando going with an almost entirely new group here. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Zimmerman.
Serge's got some
Gordon
good D,
comes
though.
In for Damian Rudez. Fournier is checked in for C.J. Wilcox. And it's Jody Meeks in for Augustine.
Welcome back, Levins. Look like you finally learned how to shoot threes. Look
Young
at you,
is
man.
Up there with Levins. Then it's Will Barton, and it's Arthur in at the four. That's the group on the four for Denver.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Nuggets.
Nah, Young.
It was a standout performance across the board.
I mean, it was like watching a cat play with a mouse.
Why would you drive instead of just popping it?
Whatever they wanted.
You know Levin's about that
life, dog. They'll end up notching another victory for this year's campaign, win number 33.
A two-game season series. They win them both and complete the sweep. A fantastic show. And what an amazing all-around game it was for Prez.
You know, the one thing about this performance tonight is the work he did on the rebounding end. He was just a hound for the glass.
Yeah, I'm one rebound short.
And nobody outworked him tonight.
I'm getting a double-double.
Stuff.
I would enjoy having my double-double, sir. Right, don't make me force you into shit,
now,
man.
Now, here is Ibaka.
Put it up.
Tight defense on him. For three, Fournier. That one.
Double-double! Now, Arthur, you're not guaranteed,
now,
homie.
Now, here's Prez. Fades and shoots. Misses the shot.
If it wouldn't have been a fade, I would have
so
had it.
The Nuggets winning this one easily. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team.
23 points, 10 rebounds, 2 assists, and a steal. A-plus teammate. Great. Y'all never seen no steals, bro. I got a steal instead of a block, which is
almost a perfect game, and to have that crowd be so pumped up.
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thank you for watching the NBA. Presented by 2K Sports.
Yo, Steve.
So long, everyone. What's going on, Prez? Ernie and the guys in the studio want to talk to you.
All right, let's get it.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Hey, everybody. Ernie Johnson.
Prez. Just say Prez. Thank you. Easy. 23 points, 10 rebounds, 2 assists, and 1 steal.
Hey, this is Shaq. You were all over the floor tonight, scoring and rebounding. How happy are you with the way you guys battled inside?
Ooh, inside game. Good question, Shaq. Let me tell you. I'm pretty happy.
I'm pretty happy, man. You know, we want to be a team that sets the tone by the way we attack the glass, and basically, I thought we did that tonight. The fact that I was able to, you know, get some points too, that's just the gravy, baby.
I cannot wait till you guys play the Golden State Warriors. You versus Steph Curry. Boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Yeah, man. What do you guys say up there? It's so...
Don't worry about what we say. That's our job.
Ooh.
You just keep playing. Back to you, Ernie.
I don't know what that was.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K.
That's one thing I don't like about 2K17.
For Shaquille O'Neal.
The altercations and the conversations are so awkward. All of them. Not even like, oh, everyone's like, every single conversation is so awkward. So that's pretty bad on their part. The writing, I guess it would be, or the voice actors that they cast are just trash. Which I understand. Shaq is not a voice actor. It is actually Shaq playing Shaq, and I get that. So it's why I also mentioned the writing. Just, throw that out there, but it's also the writers that write what I say, because, you know, or maybe it's the voice actor that's fucking up what I say, you know what I'm saying? Just thought I'd throw it out there.
Hey guys, I'm Rachel, and I'm here with Prez, one of the NBA's newest stars. And today we are actually in his personalized My Court.
Welcome home.
In your home.
That's
which
right.
Looks amazing.
Thank Stay you. The night.
Welcome to my my humble My Court. Basically, yeah, you know, I wanted to build something that reflected who I am as a person, something that I enjoyed. And I eat, sleep, breathe basketball. So when I first made it into the league, I put this little thing together.
I like it. So I'm sure you spend tons of hours in here practicing many different things. But I know our viewers at home would love to see, I don't know, one of your favorite moves that you like to work on?
Move, okay, yeah, okay.
Cool.
Yeah.
Fall right there.
We already know what's going to be.
See.
Be
favorite
at the
move.
Be at the three-point
okay, so
line, come in,
break,
spin right, dunk.
Coming down the lane, right hand.
Spin dunk, yup.
Oh.
Oh, he laid up. But
something like that?
Something
All
like
right.
that, yeah.
Guess I'll give it a try.
Let's
so
see.
So you're coming down with your
That's
right
why he didn't
hand.
Dunk.
Yeah.
Between the legs.
Yeah.
Spin.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Not so graceful.
Rachel for the win.
For my first time.
That was pretty good, though.
Have to come back, practice it a little more.
Good job. Yeah.
So going from college to the NBA, it seemed like you made a very smooth transition.
It may have seemed like that, but no, it was a challenge. And, you know, I'm up for the challenge. But, you know, I had a lot of help from the coaching staff, my trainer, Xavier Cross. Xavier, shout out. Love you, man. Love you, Xavier. He,
all right,
he helped me with my diet, my workout routine, stuff like that. And then my teammates, they helped me adjust to the pace of the league and everything.
And speaking of teammates, you and Justice Young
mm-hmm.
have made some crazy noise
yes.
this season.
Yep.
Tell me about him a little bit.
I mean, what can I say that hasn't been said? He's the man. You know, he works harder than anybody else I know. And it motivates me to work harder. And it's just been nice to see our work translate into success on the court.
And your nickname now?
Yeah.
Did you guys come up?
Orange juice.
Orange juice?
Yeah.
Did you guys come up with that?
We did. I think we were playing video games one day, and we were talking about putting the squeeze defensively on a team, and the squeeze somehow became orange juice, and it turned into a thing, and people liked it, and so we ran with it.
And now it's taking off, and now there's even a handshake to it.
There's a handshake. Right?
You want to show me it?
Okay, sure.
No, you're not part of orange juice.
Backside, snap. And then squeeze.
Squeeze. Yeah.
And then when you squeeze, you got to say orange juice.
Orange juice?
Yeah.
Okay.
They made her ass way too big in this game.
Orange juice?
Like, they just...
Got
yo,
it.
When guys should not
play video games
female character models.
How are you at NBA 2K?
The best. Anyone out there who's willing to take me on, you can come to my court and you can see me in 2K and I'll probably beat you.
So what about the competition within your team?
Yeah, it's intense. I mean, me and Justice, we play all the time. Usually when we're on the road, Denver will like bring a system so we can play wherever we're at. And it's fun. I love playing it. It's a great game.
Are you the best in 2K?
The best. The best of the best. Like an all-star, basically.
All right.
President of 2K, you know?
I've heard that name before.
Yeah.
Well, you guys heard it here first. Thank you again for coming on 2K TV.
Anytime.
And showing off your amazing MyCourt.
Yeah, appreciate it. Thanks for coming through.
Of course. Good luck the rest of the year. And I don't know, maybe one day we'll see you on a cover of 2K.
I would like that.
That would be fire.
Did you hear that? She said it. I didn't. She said it.
Cool.
Appreciate it.
That would be fire as fuck.
Orange juice.
Now get the fuck out. All right, so I've got... Oh, I don't have an off day. So we're going to go up against the Lakers, which my biggest threat is going to be Ingram, I guess. I don't know who their center is. I can't think of it. I know it used to be Roy Hibbert, but I know he's left. And they picked up somebody else. I don't have any VC to do anything with. Let's check. Y'all know that's my shit, man. Y'all already know.
Hey, yo!
Like that. So, they're just playing a lot more than we are, I guess. They're just playing more games because they're shitting on us now. Gallinari, Faree, what's up, dudes? Alright, so that's going to be the end of this video, I think. I feel like there was something I wanted to do afterward, but I can't think of what it was, so fuck it. I'm going to play some one-on-one, no, I'm good. So thank you for viewing and subscribing, and remember to stay luxurious.